Hi, this is Cam, and welcome to Super 3.0. I'm really excited and proud to take you through some of the changes that we've made in this substantial release and help you get started in managing your site in this new view of Super. The site overview page has changed. The layout is a little bit different. We now have the sites represented as cards, but you can also switch from the card view to the list view. And this is really helpful if you've got lots of sites. And the search bar allows you to quickly search for sites so that you can get on with managing your site and editing any of the pages or site details. From the site page, you can also edit the site, you can also view the Notion page, you can update a site, you can take a site live, or you can take a site offline as well, which is something that you haven't been able to do until now. Most of the changes you'll see are in the edit site dashboard. And if we go in there, I'll just quickly take you through some of the changes. We have a new nav bar that runs down the side, the Zap bar. And in the Zap bar, you can manage the site, you can look at the site settings, and here's where you can set the favicon and site language, as well as the site name. We've got the domain panel for managing the default domain, that's the super.site domain, as well as connecting custom domains. And one of the features that's now available when you go to connect a custom domain is the ability to connect your own domain that you can buy through Super. So we've built the capability to purchase and manage domains within Super so that you have one place for your sites. If you already own a domain and it's hosted somewhere else, you can update your DNS settings, connect the domain here to your Super site. There's also the panel to buy the custom domain directly here as well. Within the pages section, we have made some updates to make this a little bit easier to use, and there's some more improvements that are coming. All of the commands to manage your pages are set from the three-dot menu, and within here you can edit the page name and its connection to Notion, as well as the path. You can just quickly jump to that page within Notion, which is really handy if you need to edit the content on the page, as well as editing the SEO settings and any custom code that's applied at the page level, as well as applying a password. When you make those kinds of changes, you now see a status indicator appear on those pages. Here I've got some custom code applied at the page level for the home page and for the blog page, as well as a custom SEO setting, which is overriding the super defaults on this blog page as well. Within the pages menu, you can open up to see any of the sub pages, and of course you can drag and drop pages and move their location and update their paths. When we go to edit one of these pages, you will see the full path for that page up here in the status panel, and you can update the URL of this page as well, and you can see that will update once we save the changes. Within the SEO section, this is where you can override any of the SEO settings for any of the pages in your site, and also see the social preview. Note that the search engine indexing needs to be enabled for this to be available. So make sure that you turn that on if you want that to be available. We have a new design section, and this allows you to directly edit the style and layout of your page, and you can do that from here by setting different colors for different parts of the site. One of the key features of the new design menu is that you can switch between light and dark mode, and you can customize light and customize dark, as well as set a default mode for the site. The other really exciting thing about the design thing, which I'll get to later, is that you can now enable a light and dark toggle on the public site as well. That's really exciting. Within Navbar, we've got some new features, and that's the ability for drop-down lists. So here I have in the Navbar up here some normal links that link to About Us, to the contact page, linking off to the super site. But over here in Portfolio, I've got a drop-down list. The drop-down list can include an icon as well as a description, which is really exciting for giving meaningful communication to your site visitors about how to navigate your site. So that's one of the really exciting features that we're proud to be launching here. We've also got the footer, and there'll be some new footers coming in the next month or so. We've got the global code section, which works the same way that it has done in Super over the last year or so, and we also have site options. So if you're looking for how to enable page properties on your site, or how to enable database views, for example, or even turning on site search, these are all available here. The new theme toggle, which is this light dark toggle that's over here, that can be enabled in site options as well. So that's the quickest of quick overviews of Super 3.0. There's a bit more coming over the next month or so, but we're really excited with this release and hope that you are excited as well. If you have any questions or need any support, remember to reach out to us through the chat bubble or search for articles. You can search for articles directly from the chat bubble if you have any trouble, but we're always here ready to help you out. Anyway, I hope you go well. Thanks for being a super customer. See ya.